The Sound Machine, Roald Dahl. It was a warm summer evening. Klausner walked into the garden at the back of his house, entered a wooden shed, and closed the door. There was a black box in the shape of a child's coffin, with wires, batteries, and tools. He began testing the connections with extreme concentration. Suddenly, Dr. Scott, his family physician, came in.
So, this is where you hide yourself in the evenings.
Hello, Dr. Scott.
How is that throat of yours been behaving?
It's all right, it's fine.
What's this? Making a radio?
No, just fooling around.
It's rather a frightening looking thing, isn't it?
It has to do with sound, that's all.
What's it really for? You have made me inquisitive.
All right, I'll tell you. The human ear can't hear everything. There are sounds that are so low-pitched and high-pitched that it can't hear. I want to listen to those sounds. I want to know where they come from and who or what is making them. This machine is designed to pick up those sound waves and convert them to a scale of audible tones.
Are you going to try it tonight?
Yes.
Dr. Scott left, and Klausner carried his machine to the garden. Then he connected the earphones to the machine. It was an absolutely quiet evening. Klausner turned on the machine. Through the earphones, he could hear a faint crackling and humming of the machine. Suddenly, he heard a frightful, piercing shriek. Klausner looked round and saw Mrs. Saunders, his neighbor, taking a rose stem and snipping it with a pair of scissors. He heard the scream once again.
Mrs. Saunders, please cut another one quickly.
Why, Mr. Klausner, what's the matter?
Though a bit confused by Klausner's strange behavior, Mrs. Saunders took up the scissors and snipped another rose. Again, it came at the exact moment the rose stem was cut. He tried to explain to her that he heard the cry of the rose plants when she cut the flowers. Mrs. Saunders was not convinced, and she left. The next morning, Klausner carried his machine to a park. He struck the base of a tree with an axe. At that very moment, he heard a harsh, noteless, enormous, low-pitched screaming sound. He was horrified and felt sorry for wounding the tree. He hurried back to his house and phoned Dr. Scott.
Dr. Scott, you must come immediately.
What's the matter? Are you ill?
No, I want you to hear something. I can't believe it.
All right then, I'll come.
Klausner asked the doctor to put on the earphones and listen. He then struck the tree with the axe. The moment the axe cut into the wood, a large branch came cascading down and smashed the machine into pieces. The doctor and Klausner had a narrow escape.
Did you hear it?
Hear what?
The cry, when the axe struck.
Oh hell, I really don't know. I was more interested in saving my life.
Okay, you stitch this up quickly.
Don't be silly. I can't stitch through the wood.
Then paint the cut with iodine.
All right, I'll paint it with iodine.
Yes, that will do nicely. You'll come and look at the wound again tomorrow?
Oh, yes, of course.
Thank you, Doctor.
Klausner nodded his head, and all at once he smiled. The doctor went over to him and gently took him by the arm, and he said, "Come on, we must go now." And suddenly, they were walking away, walking silently, back to the house. It's caught in the crossfire.